So, flipping. Let's talk about it.
Let's go!
There's many different ways to do it, so I'm not going to be explaining everything in this video. I'll only focus on the methods I've personally used. I actually made the vast majority of my first 1 billion coins doing so, so listen up. One thing before we get started. I've watched a lot of AH flipping tutorials on YouTube, and they always mention specific items to flip. I'm not going to be doing that. I'll give examples here and there, but I'll rather explain how you can find flips yourself, and you'll quickly see that it's actually way easier than you think. The main way I flipped was with craftables, aka items you craft. You'd think that all of these would require really high collections, but they really don't. Most craftable flips exist because people are either stupid, lazy, or both. Here's an example. I used to do this a lot a few months ago when it was really profitable, and not many people knew about it, but it's still pretty good now. Although it likely won't be after I post this video. What you do is check the price of Ultimate Wise 1, and then check the price of Ultimate Wise's higher tiers. So for example, Ultimate Wise 3 should cost about 4 times as much as Ultimate Wise 1 does. But I mean, I don't know, maybe I'm just bad at math, but it seems pretty clear that it's not really the case. So now we've concluded that Ultimate Wise 3 is a pretty good flip. All you then do is buy 4 Ultimate Wise 1 books and craft them into a 3. Alternatively, if you see an Ultimate Wise 2 book costs less than 2 Ultimate Wise 1 books do, you should buy that to maximize profits. Of course, you should also look at the higher tiers. It's not always that 3 will be the most profitable. Another thing is that this book is in really high demand, so you'll very often get the escrow message refunding you your coins because someone else has already purchased it. Not much you can do about that, except try again when the auction house refreshes. This is just one of the many craftable flips without a collection requirement to craft. I'm not gonna give many hints, but now that you know that it works for Ultimate Wise, it's time to think. What else would it work for? Yeah, that's right, that's absolutely correct. The subscribe button. Also, if you like what you see, please gently tap the like button. And comment something nice or something, I don't know. Anyways, when you think of a potential flip, just look it up on the auction house, and you'll quickly see if it's good or not. And if you have many ideas in mind, look all of them up. There's times when certain flips are better than others, and vice versa. Anyways, moving on to those with a recipe requirement. Here's an example. In Lilypad Collection 5, you get the recipe for the challenging rod. It's crafted with 8 stacks of lily pads, and just an ordinary fishing rod, and sells for over 3 times that price. Amazing. Now, by the time you're watching this video, it no longer sells for 3 times that price, but this is mainly meant as an example of how you find a good flip. Just look through all the collections you have unlocked. This isn't even limited to only normal collections. Look at stuff like Slayer recipes as well. Do some math and figure out which are good to flip and which aren't. Another thing I want to mention here are new items craftable through a collection recipe. Whenever a new update comes out, look at the crafting recipes and begin working towards the most high demand ones that are also at a high collection level. As long as it's desirable enough and people without the collection level are able to use it, it should be very profitable. A good example of this is the Gemstone Gauntlet. When it first released, it was a very good flipping item because it was in very high demand and not many people had Gemstone 11. Similarly, Forge recipes can also be extremely profitable. In fact, I've already made a short little video dedicated to this a while back. Anyways, the same logic applies here. Just look at the recipes and see what's worth to forge and what isn't. But always forge something. Stuff like refined mithril and titanium are far from the best things to forge, but they're completely risk-free and should always work. The last AH flipping method I want to touch on are pet skins. My advice is to generally stay away from them. Due to their low quantity, pet skins are the easiest to manipulate in price. What I mean by this is that someone or a group of people with a lot of coins can buy out a specific pet skin till some price point. Before they do this, they'll start very short auctions, and once these are close to ending, they'll buy the pet skin out. Their main goal is for people to bid on the skins they're selling as quickly as possible, while their price is still inflated. You've probably seen these people in chat spamming free 4 million flip on my AH or something, and whatever they're selling is always market manipulated. However, pet skins are not all bad. In fact, investing in them is extremely smart in my opinion. But this is fundamentally different from the flips we've talked about earlier, because it's a long-term investment. You're not buying these to sell a few hours later, you're buying them to sell a few months later. I won't show which I've invested in personally, because that'd be bordering on market manipulation, but I've had moderate success with pet skins so far. Although remember, long-term investment. Only do this if you're endgame in my opinion. Before we move on to Bazaar flipping, you know what's a good flip? Free coins on my Discord. Still a few days before the giveaway ends, so join that. I'm also pretty active in there. Anyways, Bazaar flipping. Most people Bazaar flip for quick profits, and while that's perfectly fine and works very well, I won't be talking about it here. This is because it goes against my flipping philosophy, which I'll talk about a bit later. Anyways, the way a bazaar flip is very similar to investing in pet skins, but a bit more short term. You know how there's many different events in Skyblock? Just about every single one of them makes the demand on certain items grow. Let's take the mining fiesta for example. What you must first do is understand what the event does. The mining fiesta is obviously a mining centered event and has the following 3 perks. 1. Gives a 50% boost to mining XP. 2. Doubles mining drops. And 3. Grants a chance to receive refined minerals when mining. It's important to know that refined minerals are only obtainable during this event. I'll now give you 5 seconds to think about how the mining fiesta would impact the market. Let's break it down fully. The first perk encourages more people to mine, which could potentially result in a dip of mithril, titanium, gemstones, and other ores people mine, but this one generally doesn't have any major implications. The second perk is where it gets interesting. Double mining drops are crazy, and when one of the best money-making methods in the game is gemstone mining, everyone will want to do it. Now you're probably thinking since everyone is doing it, the gemstones will fall in price, but it's not really that simple. The only gems people really mine are jade, ruby, and topaz. Out of these 3, topaz stands out especially for this event as it gives the most important gemstone mining stat, pristine. More pristine equals more gemstones, which equals more coins. Thus, topaz is in very high demand during a mining fiesta and typically goes up in price by a decent bit. So now we've established that a lot of people will want to mine during this event. As topaz is one of the main components of a successful mining setup, it rises in price. But you don't only need topaz to mine, you need an armor set and a good tool as well. The gemstone gauntlet is probably the most cost-effective mining tool in the game. So the demand for it also skyrockets during this event and its price goes up. But this is an item you can craft. All you need are rubies and gold, so we can conclude that these 2 should also spike in value. The last perk of the mining fiesta are refined minerals. Since these are only obtainable during a mining fiesta, it would make sense for them to fall in value, unless they're really useful for mining. Their 2 uses are to craft the mineral armor, which is good for grinding mining XP outside the dwarven mines, and to craft a decent talisman. So they're not really that useful for this event, and they should see a dip in value, which they do. This, however, creates an opportunity to buy a large quantity of these for a long-term investment. They should see a slow but steady rise in price until the event is scheduled again, which is when people begin panic selling. You still take a risk though, as with anything. Maybe they could nerf the mineral armor or something and you just lose a lot of money, but I don't see that happening. One more thing to add here. Mining fiestas are not based on a time of year. What triggers them is coal and rarely Foxy or Jerry. If you choose to invest in refined minerals, you should do your best to be online when the election booth opens up. If one of the above 3, especially coal, is winning the election, insta-sell your items on the bazaar immediately. If not, keep them. Now what I've just told you is very easily said with hindsight. Of course I didn't realize all of this immediately when I first took part in a mining fiesta. But thinking about what will rise and fall is crucial. Maybe talk to a friend to bounce ideas off each other or something.
My name is Dace.
Anyways, before you invest a lot of coins into something, check how the item has behaved in the not-so-distant past. Bazaar Tracker is perfect for bazaar items. As for auction house stuff, I personally use High Auctions, but it's not the best, so if you know of any alternatives, let me know in the comments. Now what I've just gone over was one event, the mining fiesta. And even then, I haven't said everything there is to say about it. Using the same thought process, go over other events and major perks like fishing festivals, mythological rituals, etc. If you're unsure whether something will rise, write down your thoughts and monitor the market during the event to see how good your prediction was. You'll probably also see that something you hadn't even thought about went up or down. That's when you check Bazaar Tracker to see how the items behaved in the past. Remember when I mentioned that short-term bazaar flipping goes against my flipping philosophy? What I meant by that is that short-term bazaar flipping requires you to watch the bazaar a lot. It requires your time. How I flip is just see, oh yeah, this event is coming up, gonna buy a lot of this and sell a lot of this. It takes next to no time, I just put in a buy order and that's it. Same with auction flipping, I have a few flips and I just do them constantly. Whenever one sells, I begin crafting a new one. During the time my stuff is selling, I just do other stuff. Doesn't even have to be Skyblock by the way, you can literally just go offline and come back to some profit. So in my opinion, the best way to flip is by doing something else while your items are selling. Also, Powliner pro tip of the day. When you're auction flipping, you want as many different items up as possible. If you put up 14 Ultimate Wise books, they'll likely sell slower than if you put up a few Ultimate Wise books and a few other items. You want to target as big of an audience as possible. Of course, if an item is in really high demand, listing multiple isn't a bad choice at all. This is just meant as a general rule of thumb. By the way, the mod that shows AH/Bazaar prices at the bottom is called Not Enough Updates. Absolutely goated mod. Link in the description. Flipping is intimidating to get into, but if you just sit down and think about it for a while, you're bound to come up with a few good flips, and finding a new one is always a great feeling. Alrighty, I'm gonna flip the lights now because I'm going to sleep. Good night.